Welcome to Woggle Guides. In this guide, we'll look at how to add multiple email accounts alongside your Gmail account, so you can check and review emails in a single inbox. And don't forget, you can click on any section below to go straight to the area of this guide that interests you the most. And please subscribe if you like what you see, so we can let you know when new guides are published. It's not uncommon for a person to have multiple email accounts that they need to access regularly. This could be your personal email address or your work email. As part of your work, you may also need to have access to other people's email accounts, so quickly, over time, the number of email accounts you need access to can grow. Gmail provides an easy way for you to add a view of other email accounts to your existing Gmail account. In this Woggle guide, we are going to look at how to add what can be collectively described as webmail accounts to your Gmail account. These are web-based email accounts such as Hotmail, AOL, Outlook, or Yahoo, but could also include email accounts provided by your internet service provider. And when you add the webmail accounts, you'll see those emails just in the same way as you see emails in your Gmail account. You can also add a special label to those emails, so you can tell them apart from the emails received in Gmail. And we'll go through how to do that later in this guide. So let's get straight into it. In step one, we're going to choose which email linking method you wish to use. Two different ways are available in this process. We'll start in Gmail. We're logged into our Google account and in our Gmail inbox. Let's navigate up to the cog icon in the top right of the page and click on that. And from the menu shown, let's choose See All Settings at the top. And the Details Settings section of Gmail is then opened. To add any email account, the section of settings that we need to visit is Accounts and Import. Let's click into that now. And in this section, we're going to make changes to the Check Mail from Other Accounts area. By adding an email address in this setting, this will allow us to import both old and new emails from non-Gmail accounts, so they can be viewed alongside your normal Gmail account. To start the steps to view a webmail account, choose Add an email account. And on the page that loads, we're then asked to enter the web email address that we want to add to our Gmail account. In this example, I'll add an Outlook web email address to my Gmail account. Let's enter that now and press the Next button to continue. Gmail offers you two ways to do this. You can link the accounts using something called Gmailify, or you can manually configure and import the emails. By far the easiest way to add an account is to use the Gmailify process, but we'll look at both methods in this guide. It's an awful name for the email linking process, but what does it actually mean? Well, it means that when you associate your webmail with your Gmail account, it will benefit from all the great features offered by Gmail. It'll be Gmailified. So things like the advanced spam filters or the Gmail inbox prioritization and sorting features will then be applied to your other account, which you would think is a good thing. And it is, but as with everything related to Google, it comes with a price. And what's the price? Well, in order to sort and organize the inbox of your other email account and add it to your Gmail account, Google needs to review and categorize all your emails in the account. Which of course means that, as part of the Gmailify process, you need to give access to those emails to Gmail. If you're comfortable with that, then that's fine. Gmailify is the right process for you. One other thing to be aware of is that when you Gmailify your Outlook or Hotmail account, all the emails from it will be mixed in with your Gmail account. They will be displayed in the order that they arrive. I'll show you what the mixed up email view looks like at the end of the Gmailify setup process a little later in this guide. Let's now move on to step two, where we'll focus on the Gmailify process and how to set up a view of multiple email accounts in your Gmail inbox. So we're still on the page where we can choose how to link the webmail account with Gmail. We've chosen the Gmailify process to link our email accounts, so let's crack on with that. And we'll click the Next button to continue. So because we entered an Outlook email, the next step takes you to a Microsoft login page and asks you to confirm your password for the Outlook account. You'll see that the email address you entered is pre-populated at the top. Let's enter the password for the Outlook email account and click the sign in button to proceed. It can take a little time to complete the integration, but once complete, Gmail then confirms that your Outlook account has been Gmailified. Choose the close button to return to your settings page. On the settings page, in the accounts and import section, you'll now find that the Outlook account has been added. Emails sent to your webmail account will automatically now also appear in your Gmail account. On the right of this section, you'll see that there's also an option to unlink the Outlook account from your Gmail account at any time. If we go into your Gmail inbox, you'll see that I've sent a test mail to the Outlook account, which now appears in the Gmail inbox. You'll notice that it doesn't look any different from the email sent to your Gmail account. If we click into the email and then click on the small down arrow for more details about the email, if you look at where the email was originally sent to, you can see it was the Outlook email address that I've linked to Gmail. Now, if you need an easier way to tell if emails have been sent to a different email address, I'll show you how to do that in the next section of this guide. In this next section of the guide, we're going to look at how to identify emails sent from the webmail account using labels. We're now back in the Gmail inbox. In order to highlight those emails which have been sent to different email accounts, we need to first identify them and then apply a label to those emails so they stand out from the Gmail emails. A quick way to do this is to select one of the emails that you know has come from a webmail account, such as Outlook, Hotmail, or Yahoo. Let's select this email by clicking in the checkbox on the left of the email row. I know this email has been sent from a linked Outlook account. When we selected the email, an action bar appeared at the top of the inbox. Let's click into the three dots on the right of that bar, and from the drop-down list that appears, let's choose Filter Messages Like These. A new window appears that allows you to use a number of different ways to filter and identify the Outlook webmail. If you want to learn more about how to use filters in Gmail, see the Woggle guide linked in the description below. However, I will go through the basics of what you need to do now in this guide. The filter window has automatically added the sender's email address, but in our case, we're interested in who the email was sent to. Let's select and delete the details in the from row and add your webmail details to the to row. In my case, I'll add the Outlook email address I linked. That's all we need to add to this window, so let's click the Create Filter button to move on. In the next window, Gmail asks what you want to do with the emails sent to the other email address. Looking at the options, we definitely don't want to skip the inbox. As we want to see the email in the inbox, I'm going to choose the Apply the Label option. Once I've done that, if I click on the drop-down arrow next to Choose Label, I want to create a new label, so let's choose that. Let's give this new label a name and click the Create button. To ensure the label is applied to all the existing email messages sent to the webmail address, be sure to click the checkbox next to the option to also apply the filter to matching conversations. And to complete the label setup, click on the Create Filter button. And if we return to the inbox, you'll see that the Outlook label has now been applied to those messages and will be automatically applied to any new messages that are received. Remember, if you want to apply the filter in a different way, maybe by moving the emails from your webmail account to a specific folder or add them to a specific category, then do check out the detailed guide on using filters in Gmail linked above or shown in the description below. So next, we're going to look at how to add a webmail account using the manual method. This is a much longer process than the Gmailify steps you went through earlier, as both the send and the receive settings need to be configured manually. We'll start again from the Gmail inbox. To begin the setup process, we need to click into the cog icon in the top right of the page. And from the menu shown, let's choose See All Settings at the top. In the Details Settings section, we now need to click into the Accounts and Import section. Let's do that now. In this section, let's focus in on the checked mail from other accounts area. To start the steps to add a webmail, choose Add an Email Account. And once that page loads, we're then asked to enter the web email address we want to add to our Gmail account. In this example, I'll add an Outlook web email address to my Gmail account. Let's enter that now and press the next button to continue. On the next page, we're asked to choose which method we want to use to link the webmail account to your Gmail account. We looked at the Gmailify method earlier in this guide, so now we'll look at the manual process to add an email. Let's choose the Import Emails from My Other Account option and click the next button. In this window, Gmail then asks you to provide the details of the web account you want to link to. You already provided the email address you want to link to, so this is pre-populated. Let's now enter the password for the webmail account. The POP server and port information is also pre-populated. This is based on the Outlook settings, so if you're linking a different type of webmail account, then these details may be different, but there should be no need to change them. The next checkbox option asks if you wish to leave a copy of a retrieved message on the server. This is optional, but you should select this option if you want to keep a copy of the email from the email account you're adding on the other email server. They always use a secure SSL connection when retrieving mail checkbox has been pre-checked. By choosing this option, this ensures your emails are downloaded securely, so you should leave this checked. The next option allows you to add a label to the webmail messages when they are imported by Gmail. This helps to quickly identify which email account an email has originated from. To add a new label, click on the drop-down next to the email address and choose New Label at the bottom. In the box that pops up, enter the new label name and click the OK button. The new label name is then shown in the drop-down box. The last option in this window is whether you wish to archive incoming messages. If you tick this option, any emails sent from the webmail email address will skip the inbox and go straight to the archive folder. If you want to make sure you don't miss any emails, leave this box unchecked. Once you're happy with the details you've entered, click the Add Account button to proceed to the next step. On the next window, Gmail confirms that your mail account has been successfully added. The option is also offered as to whether you want to send emails using your Outlook user ID, or alternatively you can send all emails using your Gmail ID. Choose your preferred option and click Next to continue. Gmail then suggests the display name that will be shown both in your sent folder and to any recipients of emails you send from this email address. If you want to amend this, click into the name box and amend the name as you need to. The next question asks if you want to treat the email address as an alias. This is checked by default. You should keep this box checked if you want to send and receive messages in the Gmail inbox. If however you want to send emails on behalf of another user or account, you should uncheck this box. To continue to the next step of the process, click the Next Step button. On this page, we're asked to provide the details to send email responses. Most details are pre-populated, but if you have any problems, contact the email provider. Once you are happy with the details entered, click on the Add Account button. Gmail now sends a verification code to the Outlook account you wish to link to Gmail. This is a 9-digit code and should be copied directly into the verification box in this window. Once added, click the Verify button. If we return to the Accounts and Import section, you'll see that the Outlook account has now been linked to your Gmail account. You can delete the linked account by clicking on the Delete link to the right of the email details. I hope you found this Woggle guide useful. If you have, please like or subscribe so that others can find it too. Thanks for watching, and do look after yourself until next time.